come on through and just take a seat. Make yourself nice and comfortable. And just relax. Okay. You have nothing to be worried about. Alright? My name to you this evening, okay? Now I can already see why you're here to see me. You've got quite a nasty cut on your forehead there, haven't you? Oh dear, okay, that's fine, don't worry, I am here to help with that and make you a little bit more comfortable and confirm your full name. Okay. Brilliant. And your date of birth, please. Okay. Now, my darling, do you have any allergies? This can be food. Okay, now just to chat a little bit more about that nasty cut. Tell me, how did that happen? Ouch. Oh dear, okay. No problem. I can tell that must have been really unpleasant for you. Oh dear. And when did this happen? Right. Well, you've done really well to come in and get medical attention as soon as possible. Now, tell me, on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being you're absolutely fine and you feel no pain at all, and 10 being excruciating pain. How much pain are you in? If you could give me a number on that scale. Okay. No problem. And has that pain gotten any worse, any better since the injury? And have you had to come into hospital in the last 6 months for anything else? Alright. Brilliant. Do you have any fears of needles, pain, anything like that that will mean I'll need to be a little bit more cautious? Alright. No problem. Not that I'm going to be. do have the odd patient that comes in and has a little bit of a fear of something medical related, and I always find it really important to just adjust to those particular people's needs and make them feel as comfortable and as reassured as possible. Okay. Now, if you don't mind, relax. I promise I'm going to be really gentle. I'm just going to have a closer look to see the depth and the health of the wound. Okay. Oh dear. You poor thing. Now you must tell me if it gets wound dirty. Have you been making sure to wash your hands when touching it and so forth? Good. Yeah, I was going to say it does look very fresh and clean, which is obviously ideal for optimum. Deep. All right. The good news is that you won't be needing any stitches. Okay. All I'm going to have to do is give it a good clean up, and I'm going to put some glue to sort of hold the wound. And then it should heal very nicely on its own. So at least you won't need any stitches. And don't take my word for this, but from looking at the cut itself, it looks as if it should heal nicely with very minimal scarring, if any at all. All right. Great. It does mean that you will centimeter wound in length. Okay. No stitches required. Glue and bandage. Okay. Perfect. So now that I know exactly what it is, I'll be working fantastic. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply some numbing oil first, okay? This is a natural oil that is just going to alleviate any stinging, any pain which may occur when I apply the antiseptic wipe. Now, like I said, the wound does look very clean, nice and healthy, but I'm going to clean it as much as I can just to make sure that there is no possibility of infection. Okay. After wiping it with the antiseptic wipe, I'm going to swab the area and just clean up any of that dried blood. And I'm going to apply a little bit of pseudogram just to the reddened areas around the wound. It is looking a little inflamed, so I would just like to soothe that a little bit with some cream. And then going to apply the glue. And that's going to hold the wound together. And then I can bandage you up and send you on your way. Okay, how does like I said, the numbing oil should eliminate most of the pain. I can't promise that you won't feel any pain at all, but it will be very minimal and most likely just a tad uncomfortable, not pain. Okay, great. So first off, we're going to apply to a cotton bud, like so. Okay. And I'm just going to gently apply that to the wound. Sure that you can feel minimal pain. Okay. I'm just going to let that dry for a moment or two, okay? And in a few moments it will be able to take effect. Alright. Start off feeling a little bit cold, but eventually you won't be able to feel it. Okay. Yeah, it's looking dry now. Alright. So, I'm going to be using some antiseptic wipes. Okay, and these are just going to get rid of any wanted back. alcohol smell, but it's going to really help with that healing process. Alright. Just really getting into the depths of the wound. You can't feel anything, can you? Now going to be cleaning the wound with some fresh cotton buds. I'm just going to be lifting any of those sort of bloodied areas. Yeah, I've got a little bit of blood that is seeping out the end there. And I just want to clean that up for you. That will make it easier for me to apply the glue. And then the bandage. Alright. Brilliant. And I'm just going to be applying a saline solution to the cotton buds, as that will allow me to lift the blood effectively while eliminating the chance of infection. Any bits of blood. Okay. Alright, let me just get a fresh cotton bud. How are you feeling, by the way? Good, you're not feeling queasy, you're lightheaded at all. Good, okay. So, now I'm going to apply some of the pseudogram just around the wound to the areas that are looking a little bit inflamed. And again, I'm just going to be include gluing the wound together, followed by some light bandages. Alright. Okay, now for the gluing aspect of the treatment. I need to request that you stay as still as possible, okay? You don't need to worry, it is going to really help heal and seal the wound together. It is very sticky and something that I don't want to get in the wrong places. If it does go somewhere wrong, if you move suddenly or something like that, you don't need to worry because, like I said, it is organic and will naturally break in its place without me facilitating that there. But I'm going to leave it for a few moments now just to completely dry. It's already looking a lot better. Okay, there's no open gap now. The two separations of skin are now in contact, which will allow going to help keep any dirt out of the glue. It's also going to help you refrain from touching it or catching it on anything. Right. I'm just going going to pop this on to the glued wound. Like so. Nice and gently. Okay. And then we're going to apply a bandage. Now, this bandage is to keep the wound as protected as possible for the next 24 hours, which is a very vital time period for the first stages of healing to take place. So, I'm going to wrap this around your head. Okay, I'm sorry, it's not the most enjoyable thing to have to wear, but this is only for the first 24 hours. Like I said, it's really important to keep that glue dry for the first 24 hours. This is going to help with that. Okay, just some added protection. After 24 hours, I'd like you to then just give it a bit of a clean, perhaps with some antiseptic or saline solution. Okay, and then just carry on as normal, but trying to keep the area clean, which may involve giving it a clean perhaps twice a day. Okay. Just going to wrap this around your head now. Okay. Just around the back. How's that feeling for you? It's not too tight, is it? No? Okay. Now, you are all fixed up. Like I said, it should heal very nicely. And as long as you keep it clean, there should be no issues when it comes to infections and things like that. Okay? Now, if you find that it's becoming more painful, or it's not looking any better over the next week, if you start getting a fever or other symptoms, please progress report and assessment. They are going to give you some antibiotics just to ensure that no infection takes place. And I'd also recommend that if it does become painful, that is perfectly normal for the next couple of days, okay? It's just still a fresh wound. Over-the-counter painkillers to help with that. Okay, so that is all set off, and you are ready to go home. Alright, I do hope that you start to feel better soon, and I really hope that the healing goes smoothly for you. Alright, anyway, it was lovely meeting you. Please do let us know.